Computer components generate heat during operation, especially fast processors and GPUs. There are two things that affect the temperature of your computer. The first is air temperature and the second is air movement. According to the law of physics, all bodies tend to equalize their temperature. So it is logical that the temperature of your computer will be lower if the air temperature is lower. We can influence this by air conditioning the room where the computer is located. However, there is another problem here, and that is the housing. Most electronic devices are in some sort of a box. The reason for this is the protection of components from beetles, animals, but also various other things that can fall onto the fine electronics. These housings are the reason why the temperature in is always higher than the room temperature. Considering that we have identified the problem, we now came to the second thing, which is the movement of air. The housings have openings for air circulation so that cold air enters and hot air exits. Since this is happening slowly, we need fans. Fans have one major drawback, and that is the ingress of dust into the computer, which can drastically reduce cooling efficiency, not to mention the noise they make. There are two methods for cooling your computer. The first method is to blow the air out of the case. This creates a low air pressure and the new air enters through small holes and slits in the case itself. This method is not very efficient because dust is drawn in through these holes, but the air density is also lower, which leads to poorer cooling. The second method is to increase the air pressure, and this is achieved by injecting air into the case. In this case, the air will come out through various holes and slits. As far as dust is concerned, this method is not effective either, unless you have air filters on the fans that will retain dust and other fine particles. It is recommended to equalize the amount of air entering and leaving the case, so the amount of air supplied is slightly higher in order to achieve a slightly positive air pressure. Another thing you should pay attention to is the movement of the air in the case itself. The air should be moving from front to back or from bottom to top of the case. It's necessary for air to pass over all components in order to cool them down. For the very end of this video, I want to tell you a secret. If you don't have filters on the fans, use tights. They will be very good for this purpose. And pay attention to filter only the intake fan. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like and don't forget to subscribe.